Today's August 24th, 2020, Monday, and I have another segment of our Monday Market Update. Over the last 7 days in Chicago, 1,894 properties have come onto the market as new, 1,188 properties have went under contract, and 778 closings have been completed. So what we're seeing from the seller side here in Chicago is that condo listings are sitting for much longer currently than they have in the past. We see condo buyers between the, say, $200,000 to $700,000 range being extremely picky compared to what they have been in, say, the last 5 years. And that's because buyers' desires have changed. Sellers, instead of, say, making $50,000 on their transactions, are making between, say, $25,000 and $30,000 in certain areas. Some of the reason for this is populated areas such as River North, Gold Coast, Old Town are receiving less interest because of their population density. And we see buyers moving into areas like Ravenswood Manor and Lincoln Square and Andersonville, Magnolia Glen at higher rates because you're able to get more value for your money and have a little bit of an outdoor space. So again, just kind of what we're seeing in terms of buyer behavior today in August 2020. Also what we're seeing is the suburbs are on fire. We have a few of our clients that are trading their city place for the suburbs, and we really see the suburbs receiving a lot of interest more than they ever had, say in the last 10 years. So one question that we're having our clients continually examine for themselves is, will this home maximize joy and profit for my life to what that looks like in 2020, now and forever? To look past what's going on politically and in other realms to say, what does this need to do for me in the long term, for myself and for my family? Looking 3 to 5 years down the road from now and asking, is this home important to my family, my workspace, and where I live? Which are very different questions than people were asking at the beginning of this year. During my lifetime, there's never been a better time where a home's value has grown more than it has in the last 4 months. And that's because we happen to find ourselves spending so much time at home. And home ownership seems to be very critically important to the epicenter of our lives right now. And that's much different than where we were just at, say, in March or April. The desires and the needs are so much stronger now. And that really cues in functionality. You know, people want an outdoor space. They want a designated space where their child can put their desk and go to school virtually. So again, these desires and needs have really changed. One thing that we are sharing with our clients that we'll share with you for anybody that's thinking about a potential purchase is, let's take the emotion out of it. Does this purchase on whatever property it is make sense for me in the here and now to lock in such a low interest rate given, you know, where the interest rates sit today? And do the payments make sense for me to lock that low number in? Again, it's a situation by situation, case by case scenario, but we're really encouraging our clients to look at, does this make sense for me now? And, you know, if I'm looking down the road 5 years from now, what does my life look like? Real estate is a long-term investment, and that's why we want to help our clients pull out the emotion of what we're dealing with today and really look into the future and say, does this make sense for me long-term? So, hope you guys are having a great start to your week, and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.